So I'm here to speak to all of us about the topic, why you need to own your inspiration. I'm here to speak to all of us on why you need to own your inspiration. And I'm being told I have 17 minutes. Seriously? Do I need 17 minutes to convince you on why you should own your inspiration? You wake up every day in a country where there is no light, and you need 17 minutes to convince on why you need your own inspiration, moderator? For God's sake, the roads are bad. You complain about everything, security, and you need 17 minutes to be convinced. Come on, what happened to all of us? Remember those days when you were going to school, planning your own life, saying to yourself, I'm going to be the next big thing in this world. I'm going to be the best medical doctor, medical surgeon. I'm going to be a lawyer. I'm going to be a scientist. I'm going to discover a new planet. And then, all of a sudden, you burned out the steam. I've seen people who studied medicine and now decide, you know what, I'm just going to be a fashion designer. I can't deal with this. It's not your fault, right? The educational system is bad. So yes, that's not your fault. But what are you going to do? Are you going to complain? Because while you're busy complaining, others are actually developing the solution to the problem you're complaining about. And then 2 years later, you'll be the one, when you're done complaining, you'll go and buy the solution. So tell me, would you complain? Would you complain? Or would you come with a plan? That's my question. But hey, let's talk about this whole thing. Next slide. Next slide. Next slide. So, most of you probably love to eat roasted corn. If you love roasted corn, can I see your hands up? Great. I don't know if you ever noticed closely, but if the woman selling, okay, let me not be gender biased now. So let's pretend it's men who sell roasted corn. So if the man or the woman selling the roasted corn does not keep blowing the charcoal, you would assume there is no heat. It wouldn't be red. All the time, no matter how much energy you have inside, you just need a bit of inspiration to bring out the energy in you. So the question is, in this country where nothing is working, where do you get your inspiration? Now let me talk about myself in the next 2 slides. Next 2 slides. In 2012, when I just finished my youth service, I decided I'm going to get a job in Shell Petroleum because I had done 6 months of IT and they had promised that they would give all of us a job. And of course, who wouldn't want to work in oil and gas where all you have to do is just go to the office, look at some documents, and you see the bank account at the end of the month, right? Nobody wants any stress. But it didn't work out. They said, oh, no vacancy at this point. So I decided, you know what, it's okay. I'll be my own boss. I'll set up my own company. I set up a security network company. And the plan was to partner with the Nigerian police to see how we can improve the security of this country. And then I wrote a proposal in 2012. The proposal was that I have a solid idea about what we need to do, but I need the government to put some funding to it, 21 million. And then I took my proposal to one senior police officer in 2012, and he looked at it. He looked at the proposal, 21 million, and he looked at me and said, you come to me with a proposal of 21 million naira, and all what you're wearing is not more than 5,000 naira, get out of here. And I said, wait a minute, did you go through my record? I have a first class. I kept thinking, wait, did you not read the solution I'm trying to prefer? No, because in Nigeria it doesn't matter what your grades are. The question is, do you have what it takes to convince people without even knowing more about you? So I said, you know what, next slide. It's okay, I'm done with this. then, look at the people we're struggling for. These are the people we're struggling for. So I was drunk. I mean, I can't continue to push for a country where they don't value anything you work hard for. But then, I can run away. Look at their faces, right? Are they here? Is any of them here? All right, no. But then look at those faces. We have to be considering. So next slide, I decided, you know what? I'm not going to stop at this. I'm going to get for myself the connection that I need to make things work. So I went to UK on a scholarship, did my PhD, and then came back to Nigeria. Next 2 slides. So then, let's talk about why we need to be our own inspiration. There's a little story I'm going to share with you about an old farmer and his old donkey. The donkey has sat the farmer for so long, but then, well, it was no longer as useful as it used to be. So one day, they were on a walk, and they didn't know that there was a deep hole on the road, a deep well, and the donkey fell into the deep well. The well was so deep, the farmer was so old, he couldn't really see what's going on there, so he thought, the donkey is gone. And I'm too old to struggle to bring out the body to bury. So all I'll just do is get some people to help me bury this donkey. The donkey was waiting. Now, can you show me a rope, a ladder or something? I'm not dead yet. But the old man just thought, young man, please come and help me pour some sand. Let's get this donkey out of this misery. So they started pouring sand into the well. The donkey was worried. I needed help, and this is what you're giving me. Seriously? After all I've done, what do I do now? It is the end. The donkey said, no. Very quickly, the donkey thought, how can I shake it off? All of that heap of sand dropping on me. How can I shake it off and step on top of it? Shake it off and step up. Everybody say that. Shake it off and step up.
Shake it off and step up. So as terrible as it felt, heaps of sand landing on the back of the donkey shook it off and stepped up. And it wasn't long after when what should have buried the donkey turned out to be what it used to step out of the well. Although tired and battered, but the donkey stepped out alive. Sometimes some things look like problems, things you cannot survive with them being in your way, but this might be the stepping stones. And that brings me to a point. We say Nigeria is terrible, we can't survive, we can't do anything in this country. There's no light, there's no road, there's no money, there's nothing.
But let me take it down, remember something. United Arab Emirates is about spending billions of dollars to create an artificial desert area. Why? Because they are trying to do a research on solutions to life on Mars. Mars is almost like a terrible desert. If we are going to live on Mars, we need to start developing solutions that can survive on Mars. But UAE used to be a desert until they developed so fast, and now they are thinking, well, we need to get back to that desert so we can do some research. So when you complain that Nigeria is like a desert, I think that's an opportunity for you to do some research on life on Mars. Because we can survive on Mars. We don't have water, but we are alive. If you don't have power, you're surviving. Imagine in America, Texas, some weeks or months ago, they didn't have power and they were all shit and dying. But what are we going to do? Now, if we have to go on Mars right now, I know Nigerians have no problem. So what looks like a problem to you might be the solution the world is waiting for.
And then people can ask you, wait a minute, how did you guys generate your own energy? Because now we're all going on to Mars and we don't know how we're going to do it. But if you don't use your problems to create solutions, you cannot have that advantage in the future. It's not your fault if your country is not great, right? But it will be your fault if you leave that country not great. So, we all have a role to play. And in my own capacity, I've decided Nigeria did not do too well in their cultural revolution.
Because look at Malaysia. Malaysia got all apart from us, and now they're the most exporting. We didn't do too well in the industrial revolution. We don't have our steel plants, we don't have any of that. We didn't do too well in the information age, and now we are in what we call the data revolution. And everybody is struggling to be in front. Artificial intelligence, robotics, every country is struggling. We have an advantage, and I've decided I'm going to get Nigeria to be on the map, on the world map, when it comes to AI. And today, when you Google robotics in Nigeria, you find my company, you find my name. When you Google artificial intelligence in Nigeria, you see my face as number one. But we have to do something in all other fields to get this continent on the global map. So that's what I'm doing. what's your inspiration, and what are you doing about it? Thank you.